Summer is here, it's sunny, it's amazing, Sweden is more beautiful than ever. And in 3 days, me, my girlfriend, we're gonna pack the 1 month old baby and the dog in the car, and we're gonna go to Italy. So I have 3 days to get a lot of things done, but I'm super happy because, I mean, look at this. Look at this. This is Sweden at its best. But first I have to get to work. I have to work a little bit. Then I'm gonna go back tonight to finish up what I'm doing. This is where I work. Before we start showing some lab work, I'm gonna tell you why I became a biochemist and what it means to be a biochemist to me. I wanted to be a biochemist because I've really been fascinated about nature, about all the processes, especially in the small details of what happens in life. Why do we get sick? What happens when a plant grows and so on? And when I started studying, I thought about this as being like on the verge of every single point of biochemistry, knowing everything, the whole small details, and getting a really, really deep understanding of what life is. Reality was slightly different. You really get into detail, but you really narrow down so much that in the end you focus on the little molecule for many years of your life, which is really good, it's really interesting, you really get to understand exactly why everything happens, but it's also a bit restraining. And if you're someone like me that always like to try new things and do new things, this is not really the environment for you. But it's definitely one of the most interesting and developing environment that I've ever been in, and you meet a lot of amazing people. Research life is not your typical 9-to-5 life. You really need to be flexible. If you're working with something that is alive, that is growing, you cannot tell your bacteria or your cells to stop growing for the weekend because I have to go on vacation, or stop growing for 2 weeks. You have to be there and you have to adapt to the time of this living organism that you're working with to in the end get the results that you want or study their behavior. But this also gives you flexibility because you have to adapt. You can also adapt your work time depending on you. You can be free in the middle of the day sometimes if your experiment requires it, which means also that it's not that repetitive, not like a normal office job, for example. But enough talking, back to the lab. An autoclave. It's basically like a big pressure pot. I made media for the bacteria, which is the solution where the bacteria grow in. I have to sterilize, so by cooking it, you kill everything that's inside. This is gonna start for 6-7 hours. I have time to go upstairs and start growing the culture, then go home, eat, have lunch, and then get as much done as possible for Thursday, where we're gonna leave for Italy. And then I will be back at work and I will be working late tonight. Bye-bye. This might not be the most glorious part of doing a PhD or being a researcher, but dishwashing is important, so do your dishes. So I'm on my way back to work, but before I get there, I got some recycling to do, which is arguably more important than a PhD. Last bags. I will have to take the shortcut. Wait, I gotta hurry up. And in the end, the bottles from this morning. So here they are. Our bacteria are growing now. This is the media we made this morning. We sterilized it. We put the bacteria in again, so we know that the only thing that's growing is our stuff. Look at them happy.
Sorry? How do you feel when you do it?
It's super weird.
Super weird, exactly. That's
super but it looks natural, I think.
Come on.
There's a huge traffic right there. And I don't really understand what's happening because they actually closed both of the... Come on, focus. Supposed to out of focus.